Hi, I'm Mark, and welcome to this video on 10 tips for safely exploring a ravine. Now, we've all been there. We find really cool ravines like this one in front of me, and we want to go explore it, but we're a little hesitant because two things can happen. Either we can find some really cool stuff and bring it back, or we can die a horrible, horrible death. Ravines are a dangerous place, but they've also got a lot of neat stuff. So I'm going to show you 10 different ways that you can avoid some of that. So let's get started. The first thing you want to do is take a look at the ravine. Now in this case, we spawned in or came in this cave right near the top, and I can look around and see a few things. I can see that there are quite a few ores in here and it's worthwhile to go in. I can see that there's ledges around the top, which will serve me well to just kind of check things out. I can see some mobs, which is really convenient because before I even go into the ravine, I can shoot them. So we won't kill that witch. We'll let her live because I'm in creative and she's really no danger. Now, maybe that's cheating a little bit, but I figured it was more important that I show you guys how to survive a trip to a ravine than it is for me to show you just how well I can die. So I'm going to go through this all in creative, and so you don't have to worry about me dying. All right, so we've got that figured out. We know what's going on and what's happening here. The next thing we want to do is get rid of anything we don't need because, again, ravines are dangerous. So I'm going to throw a chest here, and I typically will do this right when I come in, put a chest up, and put anything I don't need in the chest. Now, in this case, it's only the chest because I'm going to need the rest of this. But I want to put anything I don't need in there, and I can use it as well for storing stuff that I find along the way. So I've got my chest down. Now I want to make sure that I've got the right equipment. And as you can see, I've got obviously my weapons, my sword and my bow and my arrows. And then I've got the tools for harvesting, my diamond pickaxe. I've got plenty of torches because as you can see, this is not an exposed ravine. They can come in either above ground or underground or broken out of the ground. How would you say that? They're exposed. That's the word I'm looking for. They're exposed. So you want to make sure you have plenty of torches. And then also water buckets. And a lot of you, I'm sure, are saying, oh, he's going to use those to pour over the lava. Well, yeah, but they also have a really good other use, and I'll show you that in a little bit. And then finally, some cobblestone or any other block that's solid. You'll also see why you need that. So let's go do a little exploring. Now, we know that this ravine is deep and we know it's dangerous, but we also want to know where we came in. So I mark this really well with torches, and this is going to mark our entrance and exit point. I want to make sure that when I go exploring, I can find my way back out of here because I can even get lost in creative. And to be totally honest, I have not explored this ravine much more than right here. So I don't even know where I'm going. Now, one of the techniques you can use is walking on ledges. And I'm going to show you kind of the safer way to do that. It's a dangerous thing to do simply because you are always kind of hanging out there. And not all ravines have ledges like this. A good number do. But this is a great way to get torches in higher up and kind of get the whole thing lit. And you can cut holes where you need to, like right here. This is nice without these mobs attacking me. You can see already how, you can see already how dangerous a ravine can be. Right now I'm looking at 6 mobs out here. 5, sorry, I can count. So you really want to be on your toes when you're in a ravine. Ah, see, you don't want to be like that guy. And you can cut through and connect to different places on these ledges so that you can continue moving forward. As you can see, they always kind of interconnect. Now, the next thing you want to do, let's say we want to get over to that other side. You can do what's called bridging. And bridging is just like it sounds. You build a bridge. And that's what the cobblestone is along for. That and a few other things to help us get over to this side. And we can walk on this ledge, we can go find out if there's caves over here or anything else. I think we've used up our ledge though. I think we're done on this ledge. But it gives you an idea of what you've all got here. And then you can do some harvesting if you want. Let's say we want some coal. We can get some coal. We can get some of the other stuff that's up here. Maybe you'll see some diamonds over here, so bridging over will help. Now the next thing, let me look at my notes here, is using outside staircases. So let's say it's time to get to the bottom. One of the things you can do is just cut right along the wall here and build a staircase. Now this is a fairly safe way of doing it, but the only trouble is skellies or skeletons like to shoot you off. Same thing with ledges. So you want to be very careful when you're doing outside ledges or outside staircases like this. Safer is staircases like this. I call these inside staircases because they're inside a wall. That's not a brilliant place to put my torch. And I want to stay kind of safely tucked in here. And a lot of times you'll see this happen where you're kind of going out and in and out or finding stuff like that. I don't want to step forward right now. That would be a bad thing. So you can go in and out and in and out. It sounds bad. And just keep working your way down to the bottom of the ravine. And that's using these inside and outside staircases. Now you can see we have to go a little further in even. So we'll go further. And we'll keep going down. Now, what happens if you want to get down there a little quicker? You're sick of this whole thing of going up and down staircases. Well, let's go back up here, and I'll show you. We'll do this right here. You can create what's called an elevator. And an elevator is just some water that you put like that. And now you have formed an elevator. And you can get to the bottom much quicker and easier, and it also gets rid of lava. So let's get to the bottom quickly here. Whee! Whee! There, and we quickly got to the bottom. Now we want to make sure we don't go in the lava because that would be bad. So now we're on the bottom. We got down here safely with our little elevator. Pretty cool. And that's what the buckets of water are for. So now we can explore at our leisure. So we're on the bottom and we're moving along here. And we're laying down our torches for light. And we see something we really want, like diamonds. Woot! Well, we can run over to them and we can chop them out. But what if they were up there? Let's say we wanted to get up to that stash of iron ore up there. What we can do is called towering or pillaring, depending on who you talk to. And it's simply stacking blocks underneath you like this. I'm sure it's something you've done before a million times. Oh, that's not even iron, that's gold. So we can come up here and harvest that gold. Now, keep in mind, to do this safely, you want to keep your wits about you because you don't want any skeletons hanging around out here ready to shoot you off your tower. That's a bad, bad thing. This is definitely a great technique, though, to get those high up ores. It's a lot easier than climbing back up or doing something like that. You just pillar up or pedestal up or tower up, depending on who you talk to, and you can get to those ores. Let me just check my notes for anything else. Oh, dangers, yes. You saw how the bucket of water got rid of the lava, and that is one thing you can definitely use your water for, is just getting rid of the lava, or there we go. Or putting something down here where you could jump into it. You don't have to make elevators. There's another technique you can use where you just put water down in here like that and then jump into it. Now, of course, you'd be like jumping in here from up here, so you couldn't put water down here, but you could drop a water thing down here and you get the idea. So the whole idea is to keep this as safe as possible. Now there's a few dangers you got to keep in mind. We already talked about mobs. Got to remember the lava's here. Treat it with respect, but that's why you've got the water bucket along. Watch out for the skeletons because they will pick you off of the walls anytime they can. Same goes with witches, but they're not quite as dangerous. And of course the ever-present bawling. So there you have it, 10 simple tips to to help you survive in a ravine and do some really cool exploring. Now, the last thing I'm going to show you is how to get out. Remember we put that elevator up here? Let's go take our elevator back up. I think this was our elevator. Are we lost already? We better not be lost already. That would suck. But anyhow, get back to our elevator here, and we go right up. I'm thinking this ain't our elevator. Or is it? Yeah, it's a elevator. It'll definitely get us out of here. There we go. So maybe not the elevator we were looking for, but it is a technique to get out of the ravine. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like or leave a comment, or best of all, subscribe. If you didn't like this video, keep it to yourself. Thanks for watching.